The Aussie Angus Deluxe is back at Macca's. Available after 10:30 a.m. for a limited time.
Beamed from Black Mountain. Around our nation's capital. Live from a dingy, dark box situated in a crace paddock next to the sheep. This is... Wilco and Courts.
Well, good morning, everybody. Hello, Court.
Hi, birthday boy.
Thank you.
Gonna
so
say
much.
It every 30 minutes so everyone knows. Okay. Yeah. I've got you your favorite thing.
You've got me my favorite thing.
Yes.
Is it a coffee?
It's nothing.
Thank you. So, no, I like a coffee.
Okay, well, I haven't had time to go out. I will buy you a coffee at Knox later this morning.
Oh,
I'll buy you a whole.
That's so long away.
I will buy you a whole meal at Knox later this morning.
Wow.
That is my gift to you.
That will make me uncomfortable. I'll pay for the meal. You can buy me a coffee.
No, and on
that
the show,
will make me uncomfortable.
You get nothing and nothing special.
Okay, great.
Which I know is what you love.
Hayley's very busy this morning.
For some reason, I'm more behind than I was yesterday, and I only functioned on like 1 hour of
sleep.
Yeah.
I don't know. You've had too much sleep now.
Maybe that's it.
Sammy, thank you for being the only friend who remembered my birthday this morning.
Oh, come on.
That is not.
You're welcome, Wilco.
No.
Sammy messaged me at 3:30 this morning.
Okay.
So I just want to let everyone know that we were sitting in dead silence, and then all of a sudden you hear, oh, happy birthday.
I had just walked in, thank you very much. I hadn't had the chance to look at the date yet.
You're all meant to be my closest friends and confidants.
I'm a colleague at best.
All right, on the show today, not only every 30 minutes will Courts annoy me with my birthday, but you'll get $1,000 hopefully with Alpha Bucks, tickets to the National Folk Festival, also coming along to our launch party of our Skyfire Gin. You can buy yours at undergroundspirits.com.au. We've got another enlightened experience to go to the 80s night and the flight double Volo passes. So much. Coming up next, though. Great. It's me. We're starting with me. Happy birthday to me. I hope there's less breaks of me today.
There aren't. Well, I just couldn't find anything in the news today. Okay. So it's all on you.
All right. On my birthday, I got to carry the show. And he's got a bad back because he's old. Coming up next, who needs bathwater in a jar that you're buying from influencers? I've got something way better.
Great.
So we know that we were talking about Belle Delphine. Belle Delphine, that was right, yep. And she was the one who now regrets some things that she's maybe done in her life as an influencer.
Yeah.
Who sold her bathwater.
Mm.
She made lots of money.
I don't know how much money.
She could, hate it.
Well, she was selling it for like $43 for a jar of bathwater.
How do you get to that price, do you reckon? Because the...
I guess the jar was $3 and then she considers the water to be $40 worth of water.
Hayley?
So she made 600 bottles of the bath water
at
$18,000 in bath water sales.
Just the bath water. That's before her other pages.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Sure. Well, have you heard of, and Sammy, and he's ready, you might have heard of this influencer, Cheng Wing Yi. She's also known as Kiara Kitty.
No, it's not ringing any bells.
It's weird considering what she's into.
Meow.
That's her. She's 21. She's a streamer. And she has been in trouble lately because she is doing what a lot of influencers do, and they do fake setups of wacky things that happen to them. So she paid her male assistant to dress up as a middle-aged woman and then throw eggs at her on the street. And it turned out that, you know,
it was staged.
So what is
most
the point
of this stuff is.
Is the point that you see how strangers react in this situation and like whether or not they're going to stop the egg throwing?
No. She just did it to make it seem like she was being attacked.
Oh God, I hate everyone.
Yep. She's trying something else to get some attention and maybe like help some of the negative backlash. From the faux egg incident.
Okay.
She's opening up a pop-up again. Last year she had a pop-up at a cafe where she charged $100 per hug.
Oh, that's steep for a hug. Those people who have signs that say free hugs. Yeah, you just walk up to them on the street and have a hug for free.
If you're giving away a hug for free, is it the type of person that you want a hug from?
I mean, but, I mean, maybe not.
Yeah. You're not a hugger though, Courts.
Yeah. Not a big hugger.
No, you would never, you would pay $100 for someone not to touch you. Now she's jarring something else and it's more steep.
Steeper than $100.
Yeah, you can't get them anymore, though. They're all sold out.
Oh, she did well.
She's remember that woman who did this too much and because she was having too many beans in her diet and she caused gut health problems.
She's farting in jars.
She's farting in jars.
That is disgusting. That is so foul. That
$300 US dollars.
Fart. Women don't fart, so I don't know how it's possible for one.
Hayley?
I saw a photo of this.
Yeah.
And I've just got one word to describe it.
Okay.
Condensation.
Oh, that is so disgusting.
Not the word.
So disgusting. The layers. It's all disgusting. Who am I paying for?
$300 USD.
Shut up. Shut your face.
$300 USD. And to the according to the website, it's got an expiry date. It can be used up to 30 days.
Used for what? For what? Who's using it? What are they doing with it?
I don't know if we want to know any of those answers.
Yuck!
Yeah. Oh, and she's going to sell bathwater. It's going to be $500.
Oh. there is a pilot who has made some art on the flight radar.
Oh, I love when they make art.
Yeah. People do it when they're running.
Yes.
Like they'll do a certain path and they'll actually, Sammy, one day you should run a path. And write something.
She runs on a path.
No, but like
all the time.
You know, like go out into a field in Goulburn and just run or something could just, to like, say hi
run
to
a
us.
Street. You could map the people map it and then go and make it.
Yeah. Well, in this case,
and
it
was then
they a
go,
pilot.
"This is my map from my Strava."
Strava.
Oh, people love Strava.
Yeah. Exactly. Anyway, this
don't mind me. Just 25K on the Strava today.
This man.
That's how your fitness friend sound. Sorry, Colt.
Someone hit him.
He's jealous.
It's my birthday. You've got to give me a pass. You've got to give me a pass all day.
Sammy literally posted her Strava 2 days ago.
I know. That's why I'm ripping on it.
The desk is too
Well, far. I loved it. It motivated me, Sammy.
He went to the gym once, Sammy. Just remember that.
And I'm still sore.
Let's just loop straight back around to the beginning. A pilot has created some art on their flight path and it was a bit not safe for work. Obviously, there's a lot of people who love planes and they track planes. And so they saw this on Flight Radar 24. And
I
it
love
was,
the people who are just sitting on Flight Radar, just watching it, hoping that some pilot's going to make a little outline of a koala.
Yeah. Well, it wasn't a koala. This was in Ohio, so there was no Australian animals.
You
being
said it's
made.
NSFW?
It is NSFW, so I think you can guess
Not
that it's...
Not safe for work,
yeah.
Sammy.
Oh. I think... Oh, did you...
She
oh,
just
okay.
caught up.
Sorry.
She's so innocent so with her innocent. Strava. She would,
she would
she
never...
She would know that Strava and NSFW could be combined.
She would never draw what this person drew on Strava. It is what all the boys drew on the whiteboard in high school.
Oh, it's a pen.
Yeah, it's a pen. it's a pen 15.
Ah, pen 15.
And it's
big one?
It's large.
Okay.
It's finishing.
Oh, well.
Well, that's what it looks like.
Congratulations.
Anyway, it's finishing.
Yep.
And also in the middle of it on the
body.
The show body me. Of show it. Me, show me. The body of it. They've written Seeya.
That's a weird flight path.
Isn't it?
How do you even get, I don't think that's real. How do you even get approval to fly something like that? What? Imagine flight control watching someone fly that around.
Well, yeah. I guess if it's just your own plane and you're just out
don't you
for
have
a joyride.
Like, don't you have to have like a flight path?
I'm not sure.
It's not you and your Kia wagon. Just going loosey-goosey wherever I want. Running into concrete poles and hyperdome. Sorry, South Point. So flowers are very expensive and
it's outrageous.
Your husband Bobby even bought you some servo job?
Probably Woolies.
Okay, yeah. Oh wow.
Probably a Woolies number.
For Valentine's Day, which wasn't too far long ago.
Yeah.
And you liked that?
Yes. I did.
Did you like the flowers?
I did. Is this a Google survey?
Bobby, I'm going to get to the bottom of it. Now, the reason I ask is because I don't rate flowers. I don't think they're that. Like, they're pretty, sure, but they're very expensive.
They're very nice to receive, but when you think about it, you can definitely talk yourself out of receiving them because you go, well, it's a lot of money for something that will eventually die.
Yeah.
Just like life.
Okay. Well, I knew you were going to make it dark. I knew it. Jeez. And I'm going to make it darker. There's a woman who's been arrested because she's been stealing something from graves.
Oh, no. Don't steal the flowers from the graves.
She's stealing them and she's re-gifting them.
Oh, no.
Oh,
well.
And police allege that she's done it over 100 times. Now, here's my defence.
Oh.
As you pointed out, they're just going to die. And I guess, like, if you've gone, like when we visit Pop or, you know, my brother who passed away and we drop some flowers, I always think, well, that's annoying because we're going to have to, like, just remove them next time we're here.
It'll just be and clean it plastic all up. With dead flowers in it.
Yeah. So maybe it's good that they're getting a second use.
I guess.
No? No, Hayley is disagreeing.
Hayley disagrees.
It's theft for a start.
Is it though? Because you've left them in a place. You've just left them.
Yeah. Sure.
So again, technically you're littering.
Oh, yeah. I mean, there is paper and plastic around it. That's litter.
So really, is she in that much trouble? Sammy can't believe that this is my argument.
No, I'm really surprised because I think I agree with you.
I know. And that's where I'm at too. It's not nice to agree with him,
wow.
But
no. Who would have thought that this was going to happen on my birthday? Surprise, surprise. Oh, it's a good day, guys.
I saw something on the weekend. It was when we were at Matchbox 20 on Friday.
Where were we? We were all together the whole
time. Yeah, so I don't know if you saw this, but it was around near where the donuts were. Donuts.
I remember the hot donuts. Oh, we got, I don't know, it was like nine for, I don't know, 12 bucks or something.
Oh, bargain.
And they were bloody hot cinnamon donuts. You know how barely much I cooked. Love a hot donut.
Barely cooked
barely
on the
like
inside.
Barely like doughy on the inside. There was a small child running the booth. It was odd, but it was a great experience.
Well, right near there, they were set up on one of the concrete walls in GIO Stadium.
Yeah.
And as we were walking there, we were sort of close to a couple. And I noticed that
he was a bit tipsy, right?
Well, I don't know.
Because he kind of stumbled a bit and when he went over.
No, but see, this is the thing. I don't think he did stumble. So he walked away from his wife, girlfriend, whoever, and walked over to the concrete wall and just, like, rubbed the wall. Just.
I thought he was just using the wall to hold him up.
Gave it a little tap, rubbed the wall.
I thought he was drunk and that's why he was rubbing the wall.
Well, no. I think, some guys have to do because I've seen my husband do it. He has to go and just check out, like, well, how'd they get that concrete so smooth?
So it's just rubbing.
Unbelievable. How do they do
walls
what are
without
they,
any consent?
What are they using on that? They do get a little tap on the wall.
I wouldn't tap these walls too hard, mate. It'll all come tumbling down.
He just looked at it, rubbed it. That was it. Walked away. Just made sure it looked
fairly smooth.
Yeah, he wanted to check on the craftsmanship of
it
all.
And he thought, I've just got to touch it.
The best way to do that is just touch it, make sure it's all good. Just walked away. He had his fill.
And you think this is a common thing?
I think it's a common
thing.
But I've seen my husband do it.
Right.
He's done it too.
Right.
And to be fair, it's like women touching clothes in a shop. Sammy.
Or on a person.
Yeah, I have done that too.
I did it once here and people.
Well, who did you touch?
Oh, no, I do remember this.
Our creative prince.
Oh, God, yes. But there's a different reason we're telling you not to touch him.
No, I wanted to know the material of the shirt he was wearing.
You just wanted to touch him.
No, I didn't. And I told that in my HR report.
So I wanted to know, what is the inanimate object that you just have to touch? When you see it, you're like, I've got to touch that smooth concrete wall because I just got to make sure that's been done right. And like, I probably, my thing at a shop would be sequins. If I see sequins, I have to touch them because I have to see if they go up and down. Because some of them don't. Yeah, like on a pillow where they can be one color or a different color. But some of them don't. And so you could just check that. See if they go up and down. Sammy is nodding. She gets it.
Yep.
Really? We're just walking around touching stuff?
Yeah. Like especially closed doors, like if there's tulle, any sort of velvet fabric.
Velvet. You have to touch velvet if you're walking past
it. See, I don't touch anything because my mum always made sure my brother and I walked into any shop with our hands behind our backs.
Oh, bless her.
Because we were not allowed to touch anything because we were probably going to break it.
Well, you can't break a concrete wall.
That's true.
If it's good craftsmanship.
Yeah, that's okay, all right. So your exact question is on 131060, what is irresistible to you and you must touch it?
Yeah. When you're walking past, you're like, I've got to see if that boulder is holding that up.
And you just got to touch it. Mm. Do you think people like subconsciously do this or they consciously go, no, I know I'm touching this thing and they're going to know to call?
No, I think they'd know. Okay. I think you'd know.
Now, it must be an inanimate object.
Yeah. Don't call and say, my wife's hands.
Yep.
I've tried to go as like, I went as, you know, not too creepy as possible.
I don't know, shoulder would have been better, but like hands feels, you know, all right.
Tammy from Michelago, what is it for you?
You know when you go to Bunnings and they have all the fake grasses on the rolls?
Yes.
Oh, no, I just have to stand there and touch which one's the softest or the furriest or whatever. I just,
Do you have any fake grass at your home to, like, just lay in?
No. We have cows and stuff out our way, so no fake grass for them.
There is difference in quality, though, Tammy, when it comes to the fake grass.
There
you
is.
You know what I mean? You can get a lush, thick fake grass.
Yeah.
And then you can get the bad one.
My fingers just, I don't like the dry-ish, non-hairy ones. It's got to be thick and lush.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, lush, like lawn.
See?
Tammy sounds like she really loves it.
See, everyone's got a thing. They got a touch. Their sensory thing. Their sensory thing.
Yeah, okay, Tammy, just one of your people. She's one of your people.
You call anytime, Tam.
Imagine her on like a putting green. Just down on her hands and knees going, I can get my fingers right in this one.
There is a woman on Reddit who is recounting a story from her life that is truly horrifying and a story that could never have happened to Carol Rose, Sammy's mum, because of what she did at the hospital when you and your sisters were all born. Just quickly recount that story, Sammy.
So Carol had a red lippy and as soon as we popped out, she put red lipstick across our foreheads and on the backs of our hands. So that she knew that we were hers and that Dad was then, you know, forced to follow us to wherever we went so that
and
she
that
knew that the
follow
baby
the red-lipped baby.
Yep.
Not great to have, like, red on a baby.
they already bright, come out sort of.
Yeah, it's like bright red. It's like, oh, is there something wrong? Yeah. Is it bleeding?
Yeah. No, she was just, you know, red. You can see it.
Right.
Yep. That's what she had. She had a makeup bag there, red-lippy.
That you were going to be swapped accidentally.
Yep.
Well, that's kind of what's going on this Reddit thread. This woman said that her husband was a little bit sus on why their baby had brown eyes when both of them had blue eyes. And a lot of the family members had blue eyes. So he suspected she may have cheated on him.
Oh.
So he went and got a DNA test. And the DNA test proved that he was not the father. And so he was saying to his wife, you've cheated on me and you've had this baby and you're trying to claim this baby is mine. And she was saying, I promise you, I have not cheated on you. I'm adamant I have not cheated on you. We had this baby together. And he was just like, well,
you're
the baby's not mine. You're a liar.
I've got proof.
I've got proof that the baby's
you
not mine.
You are not the father.
Yes. Thank you, Mary Povich.
Yeah. Maury. Is he alive still, Hayley?
I think so. No. Oh, God.
Quick Google.
So, obviously, their relationship wasn't great after this. They had the little baby. So she ended up saying, well, I'll do a DNA test too. Like, I don't know. She's obviously like...
Well, yeah, you've just proven that that's
she
not
said,
the dad.
Well, this could be a dud test. Let's do it again. So they did a DNA test. The baby's not related to either of them.
How does this happen?
So clearly something has happened in the hospital and the baby's been swapped.
What?
And now they're going to have to try and track down their biological daughter.
How old is the baby?
I don't know how old the baby is.
How old? Someone tell me how old the baby is.
It doesn't say how old the baby
is.
Yeah.
Hopefully under one. Because you'd get another baby and then you're like, but I've like attached to this baby.
Yeah, like I like this baby. I'll raise this baby.
I'm used to this baby. Now I think this baby's mine.
Yeah.
There's no lipstick on its head. How did we not know?
So how about that? 13, 10, 60. We swap the birth. No, obviously I'm joking.
I just, in this day and age, you just don't think that that's
possible. Well, no, because when Sammy told us that story about the lipstick on the head, I said, oh, that's so interesting. I just never was without my child in the hospital. And these days, if you are without them, they're probably going to maybe a neonatal situation.
Okay.
And so you're probably following them or like your dad did, your dad followed and kept an eye on the baby. But I guess like back in the day, they did used to go and line them all up in the incubator.
Whatever it's called. Like look through the window.
Yeah. But I never was, like, my babies were just in my arms.
Don't we tag them like livestock as soon as they're born? Like, don't you put like something on their little legs? Like a little thing?
A little bracelet. I don't think that mine got little feety bracelets.
Nothing on them?
No, I don't think so. Oh, now I don't remember.
How would you know?
Also, I wouldn't remember. I'm not the right person to ask. The mother is not the right person to ask in that situation. I forgot my daughter's birthday. Because I just was like, I don't know what day it was.
Forgot Wilco's too. It's today.
No, I didn't forget yours.
So we're hearing bad mum, bad friend. What we do need to talk about is some lawmakers who want to change something. And it's in Missouri. And I understand. I count myself as someone who's pretty centre a lot of the time. And I don't feel like I'm blindly jumping on any bandwagon, even though we work in the media and we did all sign a lifeblood contract to be a left, right? To be in the left. But I do agree with this. We're all too far either way.
Okay.
Right?
We all need to go back a bit centre.
Too extreme left, too extreme right. I'm so bored of it.
We need to have interesting conversations.
Yeah, have a chat. Yeah. And I understand it because some people who are on either side of an argument, like very far, it's impossible to try and get them to even look at someone else's argument.
Yeah.
And some of them are crazy. They're crazy
There's
arguments.
There's no ifs, ands, or buts.
Yeah,
about
you're just
it.
Like, that's unhinged. But I don't know if we need to get here. So in Missouri, they want to bring back something. It's the Republicans. So if you get confused sometimes because in the States, if you're a Democrat, you're called a liberal. And here, if you're right-leaning, you're a liberal. It's confusing.
Yeah.
Anyway, over there, Republicans in Missouri, they want to bring something back. They're going to reintroduce it because they are so sick of arguing on the floor and having nothing get passed. Whoever's got the power vetoes everything. And nothing really gets done. I agree we have to change it, but I don't think this is great. It's been called utter stupidity by leading historians because they want to reintroduce dueling. Welcome to 2024.
Like just in Parliament House. Yeah, like they're doing a sitting in Parliament House 1 week and Albo has to duel someone on the floor.
Hayley.
If I've learned anything from Hamilton the musical,
okay.
It's that dueling, bad.
It doesn't work out well.
No. Not for Hamilton, at least.
It was good in that Knight's Tale. It was fun to watch in a Knight's Tale.
But that was all about the romance, mostly.
True.
Yeah.
Is there romance on Parliament?
Not as much.
Floor. No. Okay.
People are tweeting, like, back in the day, you know, they were smart enough to take the dueling outside. This draft, apparently, of the bill that they're trying to put through to have dueling come back, says it's going to happen in the chamber. Apparently, it shows guts, bravery, shows your manhood.
Do they mean with Weapons?
Yeah.
Not with words.
Yeah, with weapons. They're going to just duel.
Physical yeah. dueling.
Yeah. So I guess you could choose your weapon. I guess it could be pistol.
Oh, God. It's usually pistol.
Generally.
Is it?
Yeah,
I thought it was
steps.
Those long, those...
You're thinking of like knights that run at each other.
Jousting.
Yeah. You're thinking of different. No, duel is where you like tank 10 paces.
Oh, and then you turn around.
And you go, pew.
Oh, they're the movies my husband always watches.
yes. And straight out of the movies, they want this to happen.
Oh, that's a bit silly, isn't it?
Yeah, you've got it. That is a bit silly. So I agree. We are too far on either side of the fence. But I don't think we're going to be dueling anytime soon.
This room wear underwear?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. You don't need to show me.
Prove it.
I'm not a free guy. I think everything needs to be in its place.
Yep.
In order.
I imagine for a guy that would be the case.
A lot of guys who love to be free.
Really? Just dangling around. Gee, it seems like a lot of work to have one of those between your legs. Anyway,
I know what you mean.
When you say work,
it just seems like you've always got something there. You've got to be considerate of.
But women also have something there.
Yeah,
it's
not so in the way.
You've got
tucked away.
You've got other things that dangle.
Oh, on the chest.
Yeah.
Well, they're not dangling.
Well, it depends.
Some of them are
everybody's
dangling,
different.
And that's fine. Yeah, I suppose.
And some men, it's not dangling either. So
true.
It just depends.
Hayley, you're rocking undies.
Yes, exclusively.
Sammy.
Yeah.
This feels inappropriate to ask colleagues, but I approve it, but I shouldn't be the person approving things.
Would we all wear them to the gym?
Yeah, exclusively.
just jocks to the
just gym. Just jocks. No, I feel like you really need to because that's the time when you got to lock stuff down.
Well, you're sweaty.
Yeah, things could be popping out anywhere. Like, you're going to really...
That's true.
Lunges.
Again,
what does
that mean? All the stuff that can just... come out. Well, there's a woman who's confessed to not wearing undies for 3 years, and not just in her everyday life, but to the gym, everywhere.
For 3 years,
she hasn't bought undies or worn any undies.
But she wears something to the
She
gym.
Wears pants, I
sure,
guess.
So it's covered.
Which, to be fair, I think a lot of women who wear those scrunch bum undies, you couldn't wear undies. Scrunch bum leggings, you couldn't wear undies.
Sammy's confessing something now.
I won't say which sister, but one of my sisters does not wear undies to the gym.
Steph,
under
the feral
leggings.
One. Steph.
No, it's not the feral. It's not
Steph's
the feral,
not going
surprisingly.
To the gym.
Oh, she does lately.
Mickey?
Yeah.
Mickey!
I won't say which one.
I won't say which one. But we'll keep pressuring you until you
which
tell
one?
Us.
Mickey!
Yeah,
okay.
Like under the leggings. She says it just doesn't work.
Hayley?
I did wear no underwear to the gym last week, but it was just because it was like... 3 o'clock in the morning. I just got up and I forgot.
You forgot to
I
put
I just forgot on? To put underwear on. Yeah. I wouldn't recommend it.
So you brought this story thinking that you were going to be like, we're all going to pile on this woman and just go, she's wild
it's
and crazy.
Crazy, but
and
turns
now you
out,
found out
I am the fool for wearing undies everywhere, every day of my life, to every occasion.
What's her reasoning?
She just doesn't like the feel of them. She just thinks that they don't feel nice. Which is...
Well, a lot of things don't feel nice.
Yeah. Anyway.
Hayley.
I read an article this morning about Martha Stewart. You know, Martha Stewart.
Snoop Dogg's friend.
Yeah. She also does not wear underwear. But she does wear an alternative. She wears swimwear every single
much
day.
Much worse.
That's
much
so
sweatier.
Much,
worse. Much sweatier.
Look, let it take, breathe.
It takes all sorts in the world, doesn't it?
Hit 104.7's Wilco and Courts.
Barista made ice cold. Drive through for your iced coffee favourites at McCafe.